Hello everyone, this is Hadrian. Thank you for watching. Let's play some more Crusader Kings 2 in our Lord of the Scots series. So we're going to unpause, and we have this massive army that is prepared to help us defend against anything that this guy here, the Grand Chief Wickeman the Cruel of Saxony, wishes to throw at us. And they are apparently marching down to fight in Saxony. That's what I think is happening. Because I don't see any actual Saxon ships. The regency for King Ewan of Pictland has ended. Excellent! We are a brilliant strategist. We have 20 martial. We're going to be a great warrior king. We have +2 intrigue, +2 stewardship, -1 learning, but we also get additional health and personal combat skill, which is great. Tell you what, we're going to forbid him from leading any armies just to make sure he lives nice and long. And then we're going to give you a diplomacy boost. And we're just going to do a raw diplomacy boost, not a fertility boost, because I'm confident that by the time my betrothed is of age, at some point we'll be able to have a kid. So I don't really need the fertility boost that you get with family. So carousing will give us additional diplomacy, which is sorely needed. Like, it's ridiculous. All right, so that's really good news. Our king is now of age to kick off this episode of Lord of the Scots, and we are in a new era of Pictish leadership. My steward Berta tells me that his efforts at praising my name and deeds have met with great success. A small army of warriors have converged at Cafferden, ready to serve me. I just need to make sure they have someone to fight within a year, lest they become troublesome. Well, they do have someone to fight, but the issue is, I don't think the Saxons actually have any ships. I don't think they do. I don't see any Saxony, any ships from Saxon, any Saxon ships, words, coming here and actually declaring on me. So it's not something that I'm particularly concerned about. I think I kind of just want to disband these guys, but I'll leave them be just in case they can help with any fights that happen. Okay, so here are the Saxon troops. I was wondering where they were. Oh no, this is a revolt. So I don't even know. Here's the large army here. So these guys are allied, they're involved in the war, but they're also fighting a revolt down here. So no, the Saxons have not sent any troops yet. Can I potentially offer you a white peace? I can't surrender either. What is your deal? I can't even plot to kill him because he's so far away. This war is blowing my mind. Let's see, I've got enough money to where I could do some additional building. I could also build a new holding. It would cost a lot more money, though. Tribal holding. Actually, it would only cost... Really? Only one tribe can limit each province. Okay, never mind. I thought you could do additional tribal holdings, but you can't. You can't. For whatever reason, I can't build one in Lut either, which is strange. Feel free to point that out in a comment if you like. I'm not sure why I can't build. I guess just because Lut, it's not a tribal province, it's a feudal province. But I mean, oh, this guy just transitioned. He's an old man now. I'm guessing that's it. It's just a feudal province, so can't build a tribal structure. Can't have a tribe in a place where a castle is the type of holding. So what's... Okay. Here we go. Alright, so there are... These guys are, in fact, the bad guys. And they have men that are down here doing some fighting. I can't see where it's happening, but they're trying to do some fighting down here. So tell you what. Let's raise some of our troops, because we can do that. Or can we? We're going to call everyone to war and see what happens when we start looking around for wherever this enemy army is. Now, this army is not strong enough to stand up to whatever is out there, but I just want to try and find them so that these other armies can join us and potentially wreak havoc. It seems as though these other armies are marching to join us, so I'm going to see if they march in to join my armies to automatically support, and then we'll go down and fight these guys. Prince Telurg is no longer spymaster. Oh, does that mean he died? All right. He died bedridden and infirm. Oh, that's so sad. Only not really. I'm kind of glad he's dead. Spymaster. All right, it looks like there is a new Telurg. No? His name is Telurg, but he's a totally different character. He's my kinsman. Yeah, I have no idea what the deal is. He's not that good of a spymaster either. But he's the best we've got right now. Alright, so we need to send him to study technology, same as his predecessors have done. Alright, and then we're going to start looking for these guys. Alright, so our war score is climbing against Grand Chief Wickerman. This is one of the armies that we need to be fighting. And it seems like these troops are coming down to join me, which is good. So we're going to hang out here and give them time. See if they actually join with me. Speed up time a little bit. Gisella Carling has died a natural death at age 53. King Sinyan's wife has passed. So it seems like there's a little bit of attrition because we are separated from our territory. All right, this army is not doing anything. All right, we're going to try and fight this army now while we have the advantage in manpower. Hey, guys. How's it going? Going pretty well. Looks like some allied forces might be coming to join. All right, so we won that battle. We have a number of men here. They're running off. We're going to give chase. We're fighting way away from home. We're fighting in Wales, essentially. Nearing southern England. Just trying to chase off these guys as they do their shattered retreat across the land. Now I should... Alright, let's move to Somerset and see what happens here. So we are winning the war currently. This will be very good for the now not boy king anymore. He's full grown. King Ewan is 17. Pretty decent stats too. Especially that martial stat. Substantially changes our levy. Guarantees that we have impressive armies with which to fight. Alright, can't have peace with this guy yet. This is going to be an annoying war, I have a feeling. Because there's nothing we can really do to get to him and start doing damage to him. Mary von Tarla is now of legal age. She became a skilled tactician. We're going to just send our troops back up here. Give them a chance to replenish a little bit. So our vassals are not going to be upset with us now because we're defending in a war. It's completely different when you're fighting a defensive war. Vassals don't get pissed at you for keeping your men on the battlefield because you need them. Everyone understands that you're trying to defend the kingdom. Thankfully, we have a lot of allies somehow that have come to our defense. Still don't quite understand it. So the current chief of Fortriu is only two. And if he dies, if he dies, we get that province. Oh, cool. So we have some additional technology gain here, which is excellent. Tell you what, I'm gonna plot to kill him. If it doesn't go well, then I mean, 70% is not that good of a chance. We're gonna auto invite. And I'm also gonna see who might be maybe willing to join if they're bribed. There's a few people, actually. So we're gonna send a little bit of money these people's way. Is that everyone? God, I wish Telurg, the Bishop of Erewhon, was willing. But he has moral qualms. All right. So those additional folks should bump it up to hopefully right about 100% or close to it. And he doesn't have any message about offer to join war has been received. Petty Queen of Kent. Sure. Join the war. To the victors go the spoils. Yeah, I can't win this. I mean, I can't declare it over. I think I'm gonna win it. But all right, these special event troops did get to fight, so I will go ahead and disband them. Let me make sure I'm doing everything with my council that I currently can. Yes, I am. Okay, there's another army there that we need to finish off. They're just doing damage. So Saxony is they're just invading here. So I guess it's just an invasion against everyone, not just me. That would explain why all of this is happening the way that it is. Let's have a look real quick. A message about offer to join war. The Petty King of Northumbria. Sure. Let's have a look here at this character. No, this is just an invasion of Pictland. He's not at war with anyone else. But everyone on the British Isles basically is defending me, which is awesome, especially considering the fact that I eventually want to rule all of this. It's a good thing. Got things sped up because nothing really is happening at the moment. We can see far down this direction right now, and there's just nothing going on. What if we offered peace again? Nope, still not willing. Our character has 1,700 men to his name. Offer to join war has been received from the Petty King of Mercia. Yes. Lately, I've become afraid that someone might want to hurt me. I am thinking about hiring, no, two food tasters, and maybe a bodyguard would be a good idea. All right, so I could either become trusting, or I have a 20% chance of gaining either of these. One increases my intrigue and decreases my diplomacy. The other one does the exact opposite. I would rather take the risk of becoming trusting. All right, good. I didn't become trusting. I didn't want either of those traits, but I'd rather be trusting than paranoid, given my current stats. So this war is still going. Pope Callistus II has died and has been succeeded by Pope Urbanus II. I cannot talk today. All right, we can't plot to kill him, and we're currently plotting to kill someone else anyway. Curious about this. Let's take a look at the chiefdom of Fortriu. Several claimants, but they're all women, so possibly their children could be problematic in the future. our war score is slowly ticking up here. Probably because we kicked his butt and we haven't done anything in a while. So now the way to win this would be to go and capture some of his territory. But I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to let the... Oh, interesting. So this High Chiefdom has been created. High Chiefdom Uradok is no longer marshal for King Yuan. So, hang on. Let's take a look at the territory. So this duchy has been created. Oh, wow. I didn't know that did I give him all that territory? Did I do that a while back? This is my uncle. Did I really give away that much territory? And I just forgot? I think I did. I just don't recall. All right, so yeah, we're gonna give Bran our marshal position. He's gonna train troops in our capital. And it looks like we can set up a new commander. So we'll do that. Uradok, ironically. All right, so we're at 40% war score now. He will accept a white piece. I'm pretty sure we'd have to get all the way to 100% war score in order to actually enforce demands. We'd lose a lot more piety too if we did that. Oh no, he would lose piety. What's happening? Offer to join war. So they have now offered to join the war. So yeah, pretty much all of the British Isles have risen up to defend against this Saxon invasion, which is hilarious. My liege, I am pleased to report the success of my mission to Cercin. The majority of the population have been converted to the Catholic faith. Good. So we're dealing with the Fraticelli problem at least a little bit. Now we're going to move you. Done. All right, we're up to 47% war score. I want to see if maybe we can get it to a point where we can actually enforce our demands. Oh, crap. What's happening here? Okay, he's declaring war on us, but he's not as strong as us. So we'll be okay. He only has 640 men to his name. So these guys over here have declared war. On a courtesy visit to the abbot of a local monastery, you observe a group of monks translating beautifully illustrated books into your language. I will buy a few books, and perhaps I'll even read them. I'll lose some gold, but I'll gain some prestige and some learning, and I could definitely use the learning. Yeah, it affects the rate of technological advancement. So let's go ahead and do that. All right, here comes these invaders, so we're going to deal with them. These allied forces might deal with them first. Holy crap. Oh, man. They're about to get their butts kicked. You really don't want to mess with me right now. That's just a dumb, dumb idea. All right. So these guys are now raiding. But they don't have enough men to actually siege down Finn. So we're going to win this too. Okay, it looks like there's an uprising going on down here as well. How are we looking as far as enforcing demands? Can't enforce demands yet. I do want to see if we can get that war score all the way up to 100. We have a lot of prestige. Probably from just the fact that we're doing well in this war. Looks like these guys are doing pretty well over here. Excellent. So this uprising is being defeated. See, there's so many armies mobilized right now over all of this territory on account of this war. Ooh, interesting. Bran is no longer Marshal. Why? He died of the great pox. Oh, that sucks. Sorry, Bran. Alright, well, we need to appoint another Marshal. Again. We'll make Eurydach the Marshal again. Whatever. And we can appoint another commander as well. Tilurg. He's our spymaster. Can I enforce demands yet? No. Probably needs to be at 100. Very interesting turn of events over the past couple of episodes. I wasn't expecting the transition when King Yuan became a boy king. I wasn't expecting it to go as smoothly as it did. We didn't have a major revolt. This war scared me as well, and so far, like, all of these islands have come to our defense. Much to my surprise, I wasn't necessarily expecting it, but it's a good thing. And now there's just some additional men. Good news, my co-conspirator High Chief Eurydach of NC Hilth has let me know that Chief Eurydost of Fortru will soon have a tragic fall off of the castle parapets. So let's make sure that this is still good. Yes, if we kill him, we're going to get his title. Fly, little bird, fly. Now just hopefully we won't become known murderers, because that would suck. All right, we're going to go defeat this army real quick. And we'll see how the plot resolves itself, probably while the battle's happening. At least the plot remains unknown. We'll just have to try again. Okay, we were not successful there. I will go ahead and cut this episode here, and we'll jump back into the next episode and continue moving towards resolving the war with the Saxons, as well as resolving this surprise war from Hordaland up here, just randomly declaring war on us, even though we're much stronger than they are. And then after that, we're going to continue. We will have a claim on Tir Yogain, so we need to take control of that territory, and hopefully Tir Conail as well. We need to control all this in the coming turns, just so that we can continue to make progress in taking over Ireland, and possibly creating the Kingdom of Ireland in the process before the Duchy of Mumu is able to. Mumu is going to be powerful. I don't know that they'll be as strong as us, because we have 20 Marshal, so that might be something that we accomplish during this king's lifetime. He's only 20 right now. We could declare war on Mumu and try and take control of these provinces one by one. But the more single provinces we can take in Ireland while they're not part of a united larger body, the better. And that's what I'm planning to do. So thanks very much for watching. If you enjoyed, don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. I upload new episodes in Lord of the Scots every day at noon Eastern Daylight Time, which is GMT-4 for those of you not in the States. And comments are always welcome. Let me know what you think, and I'll see you in a bit.